Hopefully everybody that can and is able gets out and votes tomorrow. It is important. Doesn't matter your political affiliation. Just get out and vote. It is your right. It is your civic duty, if you will, to get out and cast your ballot tomorrow for the midterm elections. Earlier, Renee and I went over some of the candidates in the different races and things like that. We sort of grazed over the questions that'll be on the statewide questions. Of course, each town will have its own individual questions, its own ballot. But we would like to cover some of these right now. Renee has a great article of it, 92moose.fm. You can get a lot of information there. Main question number one is the payroll and non-wage income taxes for home care program initiative. A yes vote on question one supports enacting a payroll tax and non-wage income tax to fund a program called the Universal Home Care Program.
And that is for people who are making $128,400 or more.
So there is a floor and a ceiling on that.
Right, which is where you stop paying into Social Security.
Right.
So it would go on, that's where it would start.
Right. So this wouldn't affect everybody. And this is why the article Renee has up is so important to go up and read, because what I have is just what the yes and the no mean and what the question is. A no vote on question one opposes enacting the payroll and non-wage, blah, 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 blah. So it's the opposite. Question two is the wastewater infrastructure bond issue. A yes vote on two supports authorizing a $30 million in general obligation bonds for wastewater infrastructure improvements. A no vote opposes authorizing that $30
million. It's wastewater treatment facilities to replace broken septic systems that pollute into the coastal watersheds, and assisting homeowners in fixing septic tanks, cesspools, and other systems that got some issues.
It's to wrench up your pooper. All right? Think of that one as question number two. Okay? Question number three, we always see this one. It's the transportation bond issue. A yes vote supports authorizing $106 million in general obligation bonds for transportation and infrastructure projects. And no vote, of course, opposes that.
Bridges, harbors, ports, bicycle, walking trails. Now, if the bond passes, in addition, an additional $142 million would come from the federal government and other sources.
Wow.
So it triggers more than a match.
See how smart Renee is? I just have to read the words that are in front of me. Renee actually knows all this stuff.
No, I am using the voter guide that
why'd
you can
you say
link.
That? You just had the opportunity.
I know, but I'm being honest. You can look at the voter guide that you can get to through 92moose.fm, which kind of breaks it down.
Question number four is the University of Maine system bond issue. A yes vote supports authorizing $49 million in general obligation bonds for the construction and remodeling of existing and new facilities within the University of Maine system. A no vote does not.
And it's for buildings, educating workers, and retaining students. Now, to get the money for this bond, another $49 million needs to be raised from other public and private funds. So again,
They'll be doing a bottle drive is what you're saying.
So there'll be a matching, but apparently it looks like this one, you have to do the match ahead of time.
Question number five is the community colleges bond issue. A yes vote supports authorizing $15 million in general obligation bonds for the renovation and expansion of instructional laboratories, information technology infrastructure, and heating and ventilating systems at Maine's seven community colleges.
That one's pretty right up front.
Yeah, that pretty much tells you where that money's going. Those are the five big statewide ballot questions. Of course, earlier we went over the gubernatorial, the Senate, the Congress, all the races there.
And this voter guide gives you a little bit about the candidates who return the information to the guide. Also,
right.
It talks about ranked choice voting, because that is an issue in a couple of the races.
That makes sense. I mean, it doesn't make sense, but it kind of makes sense. All of the information, everything you need to know about what you're voting on tomorrow, up at our website. Check it out. Big thanks to Renee Nelson for staying on top of that and getting that up there for us. It's all live right now, top of our page at 92moose.fm.